Good morning everybody, welcome back to yet another YouTube video from Dr. S. Pradeep under the banner Refer series. Today we will try to see how to do a fetal echo on a complex cardiac anomaly, and we will see the steps involved in unraveling the multiple components of a major cardiac anomaly. Before we start the cardiac scan, the first scan to be done is of the abdomen. So here in this fetus, in the abdomen, we can see that I have first determined which is the left side and which is the right side. This determination is done based on the lie of the fetus and position of the fetus with relation to the maternal uterus. So first we mark the left side of the fetus, which is anterior, and then we try to see what are the organs on the left side. So after marking, I have split the screen into two, and you can see here that in the abdomen actually the gallbladder is on the right side, which is the usual location. But when I try to see the stomach, a part of the stomach is actually a little bit midline, and you can see that the aorta is actually slightly to the right side. So these are the first few observations. Then I try to look at the aorta IVC situs. You can see that the vena cava is on the left side and aorta is on the right side. So there is a inverse relationship in the abdomen as far as the aorta and vena cava are concerned. I move into the abdomen and I see that the cardiac apex points to the left, but you can see that the interventricular septum from the sagittal plane is not more deviated to the left, and it is somewhere in between mid 0 degrees and 45 degrees. So it is a type of mild mesocardia. Also you can notice that the four chamber heart view is abnormal. Very obviously there is a muscular VSD, there is a membranous VSD, the intraatrial septum is poorly formed, and we can see that the atrioventricular valves are also not adequately formed. So next we keep moving and I try to take a Cine. So when I take a Cine, I realize that there is a single atrioventricular valve, there is a septum primum ASD, there is a membranous VSD, there is a muscular VSD, and this is undoubtedly an atrioventricular canal defect. So that's the first observation of the intracardiac anatomy. And again, to reiterate the abdominal structures, I make sure that the vena cava is on the left side, aorta is on the right side, and you can see that the stomach is on the right side. So here we have a peculiar situation where the gallbladder is on the right side and stomach also is on the right side, and I did not find a large central liver, so it is a sort of situs ambiguous. Again, I start labeling now. So after I realized that the IVC is on the left side, I came up into the abdomen and I could show that the IVC was entering the chamber, atrial chamber, which was on the left side, and the SVC also came to this chamber. So the left-sided atrial chamber is the right atrium. Okay, so I label this as the RA. Then this is the LA. Now we have to again confirm each chamber by its anatomy. So subsequently, I am trying to see whether the pulmonary veins are entering into RA or LA. Then quickly I went to the outlets and I could see that there was a single large outlet, and it was on the right side and it looked like an aorta. So this was a large right-sided aorta with a right aortic arch, and the SVC was on the left side. I could not locate the pulmonary artery. So that was the outlet anatomy. So went down again into the abdomen and tried to see a little bit about the liver morphology. So the gallbladder is on the right side. That's the liver morphology. It looked more on the right, and the stomach was on the right side. event brought the IVC up into the heart. IVC entered the chamber which was on the left side, and you can see in the other chamber the appendage was triangular and like the left atrial appendage. There it is. So there is inversion of atria. After confidently identifying the atrium and their morphology, I start labeling the left-sided atrial chamber as right atrium, the right-sided atrial chamber as left atrium, and then I try to see what are the atrioventricular connections. So when I look at the connection, I realize that the left-sided ventricle is the left ventricle, right-sided ventricle is the right side, right ventricle, because I could see the moderator band, which was in another view. So hence the right atrium connects with left ventricle, left atrium connects with right ventricle. So there is atrial inversion and atrioventricular discordance. Now the outlet actually comes from the right ventricle. So there is a ventricular arterial discordance also. Subsequently, I use the color Doppler, and you can see this is the aorta. Those are the hepatic veins. That's the IVC. The IVC goes into the right atrium, which is on the left side. That's the left atrium, the single AV canal, and there is a atrioventricular flow through the single AV canal, and from the right-sided ventricle the outlet comes out. That's the aorta. So one observation I made when I was seeing the outlet is, from the distal arch I could see another vessel going out with an opposite color. The aorta was taking blood away from the heart, and there was a vessel with red color going towards the heart. Now in the heart we could see a slightly unbalanced atrioventricular canal defect with a smaller sized RV, larger sized LV, and less blood going into the RV. Then I wanted to see what was happening to the pulmonary arteries. I had identified both the pulmonary arteries, which are in blue, going from the heart into the lungs. And then I went back to the aorta and scrutinized the vessel coming out from the aorta. We made sure that the pulmonary artery had an arterial flow. So that's the left pulmonary artery. And on 2D, when I went up into the aortic arch, I could see a vessel coming out, and then I realized that this was the vessel supplying the pulmonary artery. So we did a cine. You can see that's the aortic arch, and you can see a branch coming out, and then that is actually going inferiorly towards the heart and supplying both the pulmonary arteries. So that is the pulmonary artery. In fact, later after discussion I realized that that is the ductus arteriosus coming out from the single aortic arch and then going inferiorly and supplying both the pulmonary arteries. So the pulmonary arteries were not supplied from the heart, but were supplied from the ductus arteriosus coming down from the arch of aorta. So then we went to sagittal view, and the right ventricle, which was anterior, gave rise to the large aorta, which formed a ductal arch. Actually it is aorta coming out and forming the structure looking like ductal arch. The SVC and IVC were traced going into the right atrium. There was no interruption of IVC. And then again I tried to see the ductal arch or the large single arch coming out of the heart in color. And when I did that, I could see again that the pulmonary arteries, this is right pulmonary artery, was actually getting blood from the under surface of the arch by a vessel, which was actually the duct. So the pulmonary flow was from the ductus arteriosus coming down from the undersurface of the arch as shown in the sagittal view color Doppler. So again, axial view color Doppler, you can see both the pulmonary arteries, and this is the duct coming out, and this is the innominate artery. You can see this. This is the carotid artery, that's the innominate artery, and close to the innominate artery from the aorta, you can see in red the vessel going down inferiorly. That is the duct supplying. You can see here both the pulmonary arteries. Now both pulmonary arteries are visualized. So thus we made out that the pulmonary arteries are confluent and large and were supplied by a duct coming out from the single large aorta. So that's the RPA, that's the LPA. Now that is the confluence, and this is the PA coming from the ductus arteriosus. That's the innominate artery close to the origin of the duct. Now I am coming down from head, neck, and you can see this is right, this is left. That's the single large aortic arch. That is the PA. This is a branch pulmonary arteries. That's the cardia, slightly apex pointing to the left. It's the IVC on the left side, aorta on the right side, stomach on the right side, gallbladder on the right side. So that's how it was from above below. So again, going from above below, showing the entire abnormality. So far we have seen IVC aortic inversion, atrioventricular septal defect, atrial inversion, atrioventricular discordance, ventricloarterial discordance, AV canal defect, pulmonary arteries supplied by duct, single ventricloarterial outflow, which was aorta. Now we will have to look at the pulmonary venous anatomy. So here we have the left atrium, which is more smooth, and this is the right atrium. So both the atria have appendages which look like left atrial appendage. Okay, so it is a bilateral left atrial morphology, now making me understand that it is a left isomerism. So now I try to look at the pulmonary veins. So you can see here that the right atrium has a triangular appendage, left atrium has a triangular appendage. Both the appendages are left atrial appendages. So this is a left atrial isomerism. Now you can see that the pulmonary veins are actually going into the midline, slightly to the left side, and entering the right atrium. So both pulmonary veins are actually entering the roof of the atrium in the midline, more into the right atrium. So there is venoatrial discordance. The pulmonary veins are going more into the right atrium. However, this is like a single large atrium. So that is the right pulmonary vein, that's the left pulmonary vein. Both the pulmonary veins are entering into the right atrium. So here I am trying to show in color. This is the left pulmonary vein, that's the left pulmonary artery. This is the right pulmonary artery, right pulmonary vein, and the confluence of the pulmonary veins. On 2D you can see these are the pulmonary arteries and these are the pulmonary veins. So there is an anomalous pulmonary venous drainage and an anomalous supply to the pulmonary arterial vasculature. So this is the arch of aorta, and that is the duct from the undersurface, and that's the pulmonary artery supplying the branch pulmonary arteries. So then I do some Dopplers across the atrioventricular valve, and you can see that there is a large regurgitation of the single AV valve. That's the membranous VSD, common atrium. This is the muscular VSD, and that's the membranous VSD. And that is the view called the inverted flower vase view, which is a term coined by me. So the inverted flower vase view happens during ventricular diastole when the single atrioventricular valve opens. Now this is the base of the vase. This is the upper part of the vase, which are the flowers. This is the inverted flower vase view, which is a term coined by me for atrioventricular septal defect at 13 weeks and later on. So that's the single AV valve, which has opened widely. Now you can see that the aorta gives rise to the duct, and the duct actually goes into the PA, and that is the right branch pulmonary artery. So there again you can see that's the PA, that's the RPA. So thus I have actually slowly unraveled a complex cardiac anomaly with a lot of abdominal findings, and the final conclusion is this is a case of left atrial isomerism. In the abdomen there is situs ambiguous with right-sided gallbladder, right-sided stomach, right-sided aorta, left-sided IVC. In the heart there is mild mesocardia but apex pointing more to the left. There is atrial inversion with left atrium on the right side, right atrium on the left side. The pulmonary veins go into the right atrium, and both the atria have left atrial appendage, and there is atrioventricular discordance with left atrium connecting to right ventricle, which is smaller, right atrium connecting to left ventricle, which is larger, and in the outlets the left ventricle is blind, does not give an outlet. The right ventricle gives rise to the aorta, which has a right sided course, and from the aorta the duct originates and supplies both the pulmonary arteries, and the aorta continues as the descending thoracic aorta. Thank you. To learn more, please Google refer.medinet.org, that is refer.medikinit.org. Refer is Radiology Education for Enhancement of Radiologists. Under this refer series, I have released two courses, one on fetal echo and one on aneuploidy. Please Google refer.medinet.org. Thank you. Happy learning. Jai Hind.